The National Investigation Bureau files complaints against ex-Mayor Alice Guo and five others in connection with an allegedly falsified counter-affidavit. The complaints filed at the Justice Department include falsification by a notary public, use of falsified documents, perjury, and obstruction of justice. Elmer Galicia, who notarized the counter-affidavit, are among those accused. He had claimed Guo appeared before him to subscribe and swore on the document last August 14. But authorities later found Guo fled the country in July. South Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol set to make a state visit to the Philippines from October 6 to 7. Malacanang said President Yoon will hold a bilateral meeting with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to discuss mutual areas of interest, including political, security and defense, and economic cooperation. The palace adds a visit will reaffirm the vibrant relations between Manila and Seoul. President Yoon's trip will coincide with the 75th anniversary of the establishment of the two nations' diplomatic ties. The third day of the filing of certificates of candidacy for the 2025 elections has ended. Let's get the highlights today from our correspondent, Ara Perez. Hi, Ara.
Iron, good afternoon. This afternoon, Manila 1st District Representative Ernix Junicio filed his certificate of candidacy for re-election. Joining him are former Manila Mayor Isko Moreno, Chi Atienza, daughter of former Manila Mayor Lito Atienza. Moreno and Atienza are reportedly running for Manila Mayor and Vice Mayor. Here, Moreno was also asked about incumbent and re-electionist Manila Mayor Honey Lacuna, who said there will be no more room for a comeback, echoing her supporters.
Peace be with you. Hayaan ko na lang ang taong bayan sa Maynila ang sumagot. Ipepresenta lang namin yung mga nagawa natin at pwede pang gawin.
Meantime, former Taguig Mayor Lino Cayetano is aiming for a political comeback as Taguig 1st District Representative. He says he is also fully endorsing Taguig Mayor Lani Cayetano, who is reportedly eyeing re-election. Lawyer and broadcaster Attorney Virgilio Garcia, former Presidential Security Group under President Rodrigo Duterte, Francisco Palma, and independent candidate R.B. Bernardo aspire to become representatives of QC's 2nd District. From October 1 to 3, 31 lawmakers aspirants have filed their COCs here.
Thanks for the update, Ara. Leaders of Partido Democratico Pilipino, or PDP, are still trying to convince the Duterte family to add their names to the senatorial race. Party President and Senator Robin Padilla says they remain hopeful at least one member of the Duterte family will join their current slate. He adds they are in talks with former President Rodrigo Duterte and his sons, Davao City Representative Paulo Duterte and Davao City Mayor Baste.
Hanggang ngayon po, sa mga oras na to, kami po ay dinudulog po namin yan. Gusto ko siya, hindi siya isa sa mga anak po. Kasi talagang para sa amin, napakahalaga sa PDP na may Duterte. Kasi ang PDP ay Duterte.
Philippine Senator Ronald De La Rosa admits to snubbing the International Criminal Court as he maintains it has no jurisdiction over him. During his filing of certificate of candidacy for re-election, De La Rosa said somebody from the ICC had already contacted his office. The senator, however, told his staff to ignore them. The court is probing the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs. De La Rosa is considered the chief instigator of that campaign as Duterte's former police chief. Official government tallies say over 6,000 people were killed, but rights groups are saying up to 30,000 lives were lost.